Yo, what's up, YouTube? It's your boy Draco JCT, and I'm back with another video. And look, man, in today's video, I'm gonna be telling y'all the time I lost my V card. But look, I know y'all want to get to the juicy stuff, but before we get to the juicy, make sure you like, comment, and if you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to get that little bell, a little ring, you feel me, a little ring, so you can get a notification every time I post a video. But without further ado, let's get straight to it. So look, this how it went. I was in eighth grade. I was 13 years old. And before y'all say anything, at the end of this video, y'all will know why I lost my virginity in eighth grade. And I was 13 years old. So look, let me just give y'all a little background. My middle school days, I was that nigga from sixth grade. I was a new nigga in sixth grade. So I automatically had the little cool points, you feel me? Ain't nobody know nothing about me. But I ain't had no motherfucking hair. And yes, I got a pink hair tie and shit. Yes, Charlie Jones, I'ma be on your ass. But look, basically, I was that nigga. You couldn't tell me shit. Look, I wasn't even in a bad. Only thing I did bad was smoke my weed. That's it. Yes, I was smoking weed in eighth grade. You can suck some if you got something to say, suck something, get on your knees. But look, basically, I was smart. I wasn't smart, you feel me? I was cool. I had a 3.5. I had a 3.5, you know what I mean? Mr. 3.5. I had a 3.5. I was the coldest football player. I played running back, you feel me? Good luck catching me. And if you caught me, you can't tackle me, you feel me? I was motherfucking the best basketball player sitting on shit. I'm baby Kawhi. You feel me? I'm a 99 overall motherfucking lockdown. You're not going nowhere. And I was the coldest trap runner. You feel me? Look, get at me, nigga. I'm multi-sport, nigga. I'm that nigga. You hear me? So, anyway, we got this little dance at our school. It's called formal. Basically, it's for the eighth graders who going on to high school. It's kind of like prom. You feel me? For high school. But So we in middle school, and I'm smoking my weed, being the best athlete, and being a somewhat decent student. So it was just one girl I've been talking to the whole eighth grade year. I'm talking about the whole eighth grade year. And she was like teasing a nigga. She always would tease me. I go to her house, we'd be cuddling and shit. And my mom didn't give a fuck about girls staying the night. You feel me? She didn't really care. You feel me? She was always at work. As long as I don't do nothing nasty. But, so we would be cuddling and shit. And she would always throw the ass on the dick. She was always throwing the ass on the dick. I ain't gonna lie. But then, feel me? Like, damn, I don't want to kill that motherfucker. But she was like, well, the best time to do it is after the little formal dance. So I wait a couple weeks later, you know. Formal come now. I get on my shit. The formal don't start till about 5:30. I get up at 6. 6 a.m. That bitch don't start till 5:30 p.m. I get up at 6. Blasting the music, waking my whole house up. I walk to go get a haircut. You feel me? I walk to go get the cut. Got a new car and everything. You feel me? Yes, I got a new car in eighth grade. Nigga, my shit was red. Pulling up on you, ho, with the cream. It was a Mercury. Look, though. Man, I went to go get a cut. You feel me? I went on a jog, was working out. Just trying to kill time and shit. So she called me. You feel me? She said, you getting ready yet? I say, nah. So around this time when she called me, it was like 3:30. She's like, you getting ready? I said, nah. You feel me? I'm outside playing catch with my brothers and shit. But she's like, go get ready. I want you to come over early. This one, I thought I was going to get some cooter. I thought I was going to. I thought I was going to hit that my ass. thought she was gonna let me get some of the coochie.
No.
So she told me don't get in the shower or nothing yet. So I'm like, shit, it might be ghost time. I thought I was gonna get it.
But no. Instead, she just wanted to get dressed with a young nigga. She knew I drove, though. She knew what drove. She knows I drive. She knows I drive.
So I get over there, and she ends up doing her little swimsuit, little top and bottoms. I'm like, your mom's not here? She say no. I said, what time she get back? She say she not. But I go upstairs, and it's four other girls. So it's five. It's six of us all together, five girls, and it's me. You feel me? I mean, I'm like, hold on, let me call some of the homies. There's too many girls. I can't handle this by myself. She like, nah, you don't need to call nobody. We all going together. Now, everybody wearing blue. We and this bitch looking like Smurfs, for real. For real, a lot of Smurfettes, and it's just me. So, we get to the little dance, you feel me? Everybody dancing. Now, this one, Red Nose, was hot. I'm on the wall, cool. You know how cool niggas be. Be on the wall, cool, with the little fruit punch in their hand, had the pinky up. Because I know I'm that nigga, like, couldn't nobody tell me nothing. Had the pinky up, drinking in with the homeboys, feel me? Talking about what we gonna do after and shit, whatever. So, I get to ask her, like, where we going after this? She say she having a party at the crib. She ain't tell me. Now, we talk. This my bitch. She ain't tell me she was having a party, but it's cool. It's cool. Everybody parents, you feel me? Everybody parents this night was gone. I don't know where the fuck they was at. They was out of town when nobody parents gonna be home or nothing. So, after the little formal, you feel me? She, at the little formal, she was grinding on a nigga. You feel me? She was, all this money on me. Said, I'm gonna tell you from the, I just want to, she gonna, like a red nose. I was hitting that motherfucker, but then her friend come up on me like, you can dance with me. My day had left me and shit. She said so, you feel me? Yes. I said yes, so I let her dance and shit. Said so. And I had two. I had two. I ain't sharing. I had two. Shit. So I'm behind these hoes like I'm, you feel me? Like I'm behind the BBW, you feel me? You feel me? Y'all both get a little bit of the PB. But then she had got mad and was like, I'ma go, I wanna leave this and this and that, but I'm not leaving, shorty. So she left for her friends, but my clothes I had came in was still at her house. So she said, I'ma just see you at the house. I don't feel like being here. She kind of blew my mind trying to come up on you and dance to this song. I wasn't giving a fuck. We just talk, bitch. We don't date. I don't love the thotties. But this shit stupid. So I'm like, damn, I don't got no date. I'm lying. It's so many girls in here. It's Mr. Still Your Girl. I'm Mr. Still Your Girl. So you know what I did. I had the friend. I needed a plus one. So I went to go get me one. One of the hoes in the five. One of the Smurfettes. So we having a good time or whatever. So the dance end. I call up old girl. You feel me? Like, you feel me? What we finna do now? You feel me? The dance done over with. Can we come over to the crib or what? So I done told everybody. Now, when I tell motherfuckers to come, oh, they gonna come. For sure they gonna come. Like, they know they gonna smoke some weed. Eighth grade motherfuckers was getting drunk as hell. I ain't gonna lie. I don't drink. Now, I wasn't drinking shit, but some motherfucking water. But I don't drink. But we was getting high as fuck. I was rolling all the weed. We was getting high as hell. So we go to the house. You feel me? Everybody getting high, drunk, whatever. She say, everybody, anybody who here now can stay tonight. It was like 10. The dance in at like 8. It's like 10 now. So everybody done went to sleep. Everybody either high, drunk as hell, whatever. So it's like three girls up. So he playing 7 Minutes of Heaven and shit. And it's two. I had two other homeboys up. We had two other homeboys up. So it's like even and shit. We playing 7 Minutes of Heaven and shit. Man, that's when I thought it was gonna go down. Cause it was like my shorty. You feel me? My shorty was up. So I'm like, you feel me? So we get in the closet.
Yes, we was really in the closet. But it was a walk-in closet, so we cool. So, we get in the closet, so I'm like, you feel me? So, remember you said I was going to get a piece of the cookie tonight. She's like, well, yeah, but that's until you were dancing with my friend at the formal. Ah, boy, what the fuck? I was mad. It's how I was ready to square with me, motherfucker. I was going to hit her ass with something. But then, so, you feel me? I'm just like, it's all right. You feel me? It's all right. I can't wait. So, we just started making out and shit. She was like, well, tonight, you can finger me. Now, if you knew me in that grade, you know I was fingering nasty. Fingering shit. You feel me? You got, this how you finger. You got to use these two and this. Hey, hey. He got to go crazy on the clit, and they got to go crazy like it's the dick. Oh, shit. But look, man, so we get done playing that, everybody eventually sleep. I'm still up. Now, I'm the only nigga that's up. So I go get me. It's motherfucking sleep everywhere, first of all. It's motherfucking sleep in the room, in the kitchen. Yes, in the kitchen, bro. They sleep on the table. In the kitchen, in the living room, the basement, the garage, everywhere. Everybody just motherfuckers everywhere. It was at least 65 people, bro. We gone as hell. Everybody parents knew that they was coming to her house. It was whatever, bro. So I go get me something to drink. Because I did smoke by myself. And if you smoke, you know your mouth gets dry as fuck. And water ain't going to do it. So I went to go get me something to drink. Man. So remember the girl I told you I was a little friend I was at the dance who was on me, right? So I ain't had no shirt on. I ain't had no shirt on at all. You feel me? I was showing off the muscles. You know, that's when I was showing off the six-pack, for real. That's when I had the six-pack going crazy. But, showing off the six-pack or whatever, but look. So, she tell me, like, I'm cold, I don't have a cover, so I want to go get her a cover and shit. She like, can you lay with me? Everybody around me just has negative energy and this and this. And I said, what you mean? What you mean negative energy? We just got done turning the fuck up, like, not too long ago. She like, well, I kind of like you, and I broke up with my boyfriend because I want to get some dick from you. You said you wanted to get some what? You feel me? So she like, she wanted to get some dick. But now, I lasted 30 seconds to a minute. But, you feel me? So I get to make it, not where, you feel me? We going nutty. Put my tongue all down the throat and shit. But, so, we on the couch. She got the good spot. She got the big couch. Yes. We on the couch, goddamn. So, we on the couch and shit. I ain't know what I was doing. So, she was giving me some sloppy, like, she wasn't sucking, but she was just spitting, just using all saliva. Like, just all saliva. She was sucking, but she was just spitting my shit. So, I ain't know what to do. So she like, well, she look up at me and shit. She like, well, you want to have sex? Yes, sir. I told her ass. And I was like, shit, if you want to. So I'm like, how, like, what's your favorite position and shit? So she talking about some. I ain't really know the sex name, you feel me? Before I got grown, you feel me? I was a little kid when it was coming to the coochie, you feel me? She was like, well, I like to turn around to where my butt is facing. That's the doggy style. She likes the doggy style. Fat ass booty with the doggy style. So, you hear me? She's like, I don't like to start up though. I like to start up with you from the front. So I'm thinking she want me to eat the coochie. So I off the rip, nigga, off the bat. I told her I don't eat the coochie. I told her that's something. I don't do that. I don't eat the coochie. I don't eat that. It's like, no, I just want your dick. You hear me? Yes, sir. So look. So I was like, shit, you know, I'm trying to play it cool and shit. I lay back. I'm like, yeah, you feel me? Come here, let me unbutton your pants. The big hat on, the skinniest jeans ever. I'm sitting there strong as hell trying to get this motherfucking button loose. And it's about three of them, high-waisted. This one high-waisted was coming in style. So I'm sitting there, you feel me, getting the buttons off. Finally unzipped that thing. She was ready. She had no panties on. Coochie freshly shaved. So she lays on the back, you feel me? And I goes down like, hey, hey, I only lasted about a couple seconds. She was like, you done? I said, shit, I'm ready to go to sleep. Boy, when I tell you, I went for round two. Yes, sir, I went for round two. Now, you feel me? This time, you feel me? After you get the nut off, so bitch, you ain't going enough for another hour, 50 minutes. Boy, I was going, ha, 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 ha. I'm hitting it with my hands up. I'm hitting it behind my head, nigga. I'm nay-naying in that motherfucker, you feel me? I'm red-nosing in her shit. I'm going dumb. So, it's just a lot of... And she got the cover in her mouth and shit, pillow on her face, finna suffocate and some more shit. So, we was fucking for about 2 hours. I ain't gonna lie. We was fucking for about 2 hours. Next thing you know, I see the girl wake up. Shady had woke up, came out the room... Basically had caught us. Yeah, and she had caught us. Kicked us both out the spot. And then, so I was driving, so I ain't ready to get no fuck. You feel me? She thought she was doing something. I got a key to my house, shorty. I'm living. I don't give a fuck. So and then, I had got to the crib, and like an hour later, she FaceTimed me. FaceTimed me was like crying and shit. Everybody was trying to bash my name and shit. I wasn't giving a fuck. I just got some nooker. Fucking a little female for the first time is the best thing ever. You feel me? Use protection because I almost nutted. I would have had a little mini me rolling around here right now. Pull out game is A1. You hear me? Just like some sauce. But no, for real, man. That's the end of the story. That's how I lost my virginity.
If y'all like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to follow me on all social medias. Links will be down in the description down below. Without further ado, I'm going to catch y'all in the next video.